Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to look at Massive and just show you a couple things you may have overlooked. So in Massive, what I like to do is break it down into modules. It's easier to understand it when you look at everything as a separate piece to the puzzle rather than as one big screen. Okay, so as you can see, they have visually made it a little easier on the eyes. Everything looks like, you know, a little box or container, and we'll call that a module in this case. Okay, so each of these modules, each of these little boxes has their own function to the sound. Okay, so if you ever get lost, just look at the next module and see what it is. And of course, we go over Massive in depth at BusyWorksBeats.com for premium members. But here, I'm just going to go through and show you some things you just may have overlooked or just haven't been aware of. Okay, so in Massive, it's a wavetable synth. So there are two different shapes per wavetable. Okay, so that's what the WT stands for, wavetable. So I can switch between a square wave and a sawtooth. Okay, if you've used Serum, they have a visual wavetable where you can actually see the shape you are transforming into, similar to Zebra as well, by UHE. Okay, so it's a wavetable synth. So we can use those two different shapes for different tones and different harmonic structures. So some people like to modulate that knob, meaning that knob will move over time. So that's what people like to do to create different tones and have it cycle between the two. So let's look at each module. I'm not going to go into depth about a full tutorial about this. Again, you can go to BusyWorksBeats.com for premium members for more information about Massive. We go over the plugin in depth. When you search in the video section, you could just type it in Massive and it'll pop up. So let's build a sound. Okay, so the easiest way to learn Massive is to apply the technology right away. So let's start with a square wave. Now, I'm not going to go over everything about sound design. So keep in mind, we're not going to go in depth about sound design. The point here is just to look at Massive and see what you may have been overlooking or cool ways to think about Massive. So let's start with a square wave at a lower octave. So we're going to pull our coarse pitch down 12 semitones. Let's go negative 12. So we have a nice bitey bass. Now I'm going to run this through filter 2. Okay, usually people run it through filter 1, which is fine, but I'm actually going to run it through filter 2. And the filters are running in parallel, meaning they're running at the same time. Okay, so if you had something going through filter 1 and 2, it would run through the filters at the same time and combine the sound later. I'm going to dedicate this oscillator specifically to filter 2. Okay, now the filter is not set to anything right now. In the filter, I'm going to create a low pass filter. So let's click here. Let's go to low pass and let's turn up the cutoff so we can actually hear some of those low frequencies. Now this knob is the filter out. So if it's too quiet, you can always turn that for extra gain. So now we have a nice bass focused sound. When I play those high notes, you really can't hear them. You can, but the filter is cutting out those high frequencies for the most part. Okay. Now let's move into, now let's give that an envelope. So what I wanted to do is envelope 3. So by default, envelope 4 is controlling your main amplitude. So you want to leave that alone unless you want that to match the other modulation you're doing. So we're going to use envelope 3 to modulate the pitch, because I want the pitch to go down sharply for that section. Okay, so let's drag that into that box, oscillator 3, and I'm going to tell it to start high and go low over time. So let's tell it to start at about 24 semitones up, which is 2 octaves up, and you can hear it go down in pitch. Now you can't hear it as much because we have the filter on, so let me turn the filter off. That's what it sounds like based on envelope 3. The pitch is moving in the shape. It goes then it evens out. So what I wanted to do is go and stop. So let's lower the decay level so the pitch goes from high to low very quickly. so it just adds a transient pitch bend, and this is great for kind of kick style. Kick style sounds, and I'm also going to get rid of any sustain. Oh, you know what? That's the amp envelope. I can't control that. So anyway, I'm not going to mess with the amp envelope. I just want the beginning of this sound to sound very pitch sensitive. So I'm shortening up that into pew, pew, pew. It just adds a little more energy in the transient. Okay, now you can increase your range to make that more exaggerated. So every 12 semitones is an octave. So now you hear more of a lasery sound because we're going up, you know, four octaves. So let's pull that back down to 24, which is a reasonable two octaves up. Let's add the filter back. So without the envelope, I'm not sure if we can bypass an envelope. Let me see here. Could just get rid of it. Let me see here. Off. Okay, yeah. So here's without. And here's with. You now hear that poof, poof in the beginning. So that's where the punch comes from. It just adds a little more aggression in the tone. Now, oscillator 2, we're going to use that to dirty up the sound. We're going to use this almost like a built-in distortion without using distortion. To do that, we're going to go an octave lower than the pitch of oscillator 1. So this is almost like an LFO. So now I'm going to use a square tone at an octave lower than oscillator 1 to add grit to the sound. And we want to turn up the amplitude. And you can hear it adds that grit. Really low frequencies, this is what it's doing to the audio. When you combine it, it's almost like an LFO, especially if we drop it down. Let's go one more octave, so that'd be negative 36. So it's almost distorting the sound using an oscillator. And you can do that for tone. You got to be careful because it starts to make the tone sound out of tune sometimes. So I just like to use a little bit. So this is if you're trying to create your own trap 808s. This would be a good technique to use for the dance club because they're not as southern as the southern 808s. These are more club 808s because it has some characteristics of a 909 drum machine mixed with an 808. So the oscillator 3, we could use this for upper harmonics. I'm just going to leave it alone. We really don't need another oscillator in the sound. Now the modulation envelopes, I'm not going to get into the modulation oscillator, but you can add ring mods if you don't know what that is. You can go to busyworksbeats.com/sounddesign. We have a free course for you on sound design. Now for the sound, let's add a little coloration using white noise for a little more scratchy tone. I'm going to turn up the amplitude for the white noise and change the color. The color is basically the frequency focus. So if I pull the color up, we're going to get higher frequency. More of a scratchy tone. And that's what I want. I'm just going to turn that amp down a bit. So that adds like a texture to the sound. It makes it feel more scratchy. And also white noise is great for making your impacts sound more aggressive. So that can also be modulated by an envelope. So let's use envelope 3 to modulate the amplitude here. Okay, and let's tell it to start high, I believe. So it has the same transient shape as the pitch bend we used on oscillator 1. So it's like a click, like tick, tick. That's all we're adding. So you get that. Now, feedback is a little less controllable. If you're familiar with Reactor, you know the load knob on Reactor 5's Monarch. Basically, that's what it does. But it's a little more, people use it for coloration, but I find it almost uncontrollable unless you give it an envelope. You got to be really careful with feedback loops. It's kind of like with a microphone, how you hear that like whistle sound sometimes where it goes, you know, and the mic goes crazy on stage because it was feedbacking into the mic. So that kind of sound, but lower frequencies usually. Now let's look at running the distortion through filter one, but making that a high pass filter. So we don't get any of that low frequency. We're just getting the distorted tone. Now, distorted tone can be the harmonic or it can be what it does as far as an LFO to oscillator one. So just because I'm running this through a high pass filter doesn't mean it will maintain its distortion effects, oscillator two, that is. Let's run that through filter one. Let's make this a high pass filter, which is different, the complete opposite of a low pass. And let's solo this so we can hear what's going on. So you can see I'm cutting out the low frequencies and leaving that kind of saturated sound. Okay, but the question is, will it still make the sound feel distorted? So it does give the illusion that it's distorted. Okay, so there's two ways to think about oscillator two. It can be an LFO type of thought process, or it can just be an overtone thought process. Are we perceiving distortion through overtones, or is the LFO, the low frequency of oscillator two, modulating oscillator one so that it feels distorted? So there's two ways to think about distortion that way, without even using a plugin for distortion. So let's get into some of these bottom modules here. These are additional effects, usually more wave shaping effects or distortion effects. Let's go with the sine shaper. And this is going to add a little more grit to the sound. Feels like a tremolo effect, and tremolo is when you modulate volume going up and down over time. So that's what it feels like. Let's try a bit crush effect. For this sound, you're not really hearing much. Okay, I'm not really getting much from that. Let's do a parabolic shaper. So if you are familiar with ring modulation or frequency modulation, that's basically what these are doing to the sound. You can hear it wobbling, going, you know, that tremolo type of sound. So the sine shaper was okay. Just for an additional overtone. I'm not going to use insert 2. So there are many different functionalities we're not really even touching on, but what I'm going to do is activate portamento. So let's go to voicing. Let's turn it on monophonic because I only want one voice at a time. Let's go to oscillator. And let's turn up the time it takes to pitch bend between notes. Adds a little more flavor to our 808 than just having a typical 808. So that's a really cool way to think about sound design. Sound design is a thought process, not only knowing the plugin, but thinking about it on higher levels. Again, you can go to busyworksbeats.com/sounddesign to learn more. We'll leave a link below. I'm not going to even touch into the envelopes and the LFOs and performance because I don't need those for this specific sound. Lastly, an effect I would add, I wouldn't really add an effect on an 808, If anything, it'd be tube distortion. So let's try some tube distortion. And that adds a little more aggression to the sound. Really cool, unique sound. So that's how you can think about sound design and come up with your own unique 808s, your own bass. There's many different ways. Again, you want to get started. If you're confused about the terminologies and the process, go to busyworksbeats.com/sound design. There we have a free course on sound design, the fundamentals of sound design. If you want to learn more about the Massive plugin, go to busyworksbeats.com and join now as a premium member. Thanks for watching. BusyWorksBeats.com.